great principles do not live from generation to generation without being nurtured, without being kept vigorously alive. Unless we understand and work effectively for the principles upon which our American way of life is founded, the structure will crumble and our heritage of freedom will perish.
The Southern revolt against President Truman reaches its climax at Birmingham under the states' rights banner, and to join in the protest against the president's civil rights program.
There's not enough troops in the army to force the Southern people to break down segregation and admit the Negroes into our theaters, into our springs.
And segregation forever.
Well, that you can't even read the Bible. The Supreme Court of the United States has held. Now, you know, all property has been taken in Russia and in China for the use of the public. All private property has been taken for the public use, such as the Civil Rights Bill would take your father's business and use it for the public use.
But there are other communists who don't show their real faces, who work more silently.
Represent the majority of the people in Alabama who hate niggerism, Catholicism, Judaism, and all the isms of the whole world. So said the Alabama Ku Klux Klan. Also said, I like Barry Goldwater.
Extremism in the defense of liberty is no vice.
Over and over, Negroes repeat the charge of police brutality.
The mobs might groan and curse in disappointment when a white got away. The burning and looting, the shooting and beating went on for nearly a week.
Everyone goes to see the way a washerwoman washes her clothes.
If you like boogie woogie rhythm, she's got...
The commission will investigate the origins of the recent disorders. It will make recommendations to me, to the Congress, to the state leaders to prevent or contain such disasters in the future.
Let us recognize that the first civil right of every American is to be free from domestic violence. So I pledge to you, we shall have order in the United States.
There is a feeling that for some reason somebody owes them a living.
Just about half of whites said the Negro has not worked hard enough. 15% blames When Negroes riot in our ghettos, what is to blame? Great numbers of whites say it is largely because of a communist plot. More than a third of whites say that when a riot occurs, it would be a good idea for police to shoot one or two rioters as examples to the rest.
Where does Carter stand on the issues? Certainly to the left of the man he has to beat, George Wallace.
And we've got another 2-3 million that have given up hope of getting jobs, another 1.5 million on welfare that have never looked for jobs because they don't have the motivation or understanding.
The more children they can have, the more money they get to go out and play the lottery, they get more money to go out and drink a little more gin. But
the Federal Elections Commission voted today to allow corporations to solicit campaign contributions from...
I feel that they're basically lazy.
You are Americans. You're the product of the freest society mankind has ever known. No one ever has the right to destroy your dreams and shatter your life. As we mobilize for this national crusade, we need the creativity of your enterprise applied directly to this national problem. America must stand for something, and that our heritage lets us stand with a strength of character made more steely by each layer of challenge pressed upon the nation. We Americans have never been morally neutral against any form of tyranny.
Just a good old boy, never meaning no harm. Beats all you never saw. Been in trouble with the law since the day they was born. Straightening the curves, flattening the hills. Someday the mountain might get them, but the law never will.
Well, some folks might have come so they could tell their grandchildren they saw President Reagan. Most of them just stopped by to say, thanks.
Back up, back up! Get him out!
Bush supports the death penalty for first-degree murderers. Dukakis not only opposes the death penalty, he allowed first-degree murderers to have weekend passes. Was Willie Horton, who murdered a boy in a robbery, stabbed. Horton fled, kidnapped a young couple, stabbing the man and repeatedly raping his girlfriend. Weekend prison passes. Dukakis on crime.
We're a nation of laws. We must increase respect for the law. We must pass strong legislation to help the fight against crime and to back up our police officers.
He should obey the law. If there's laws for us, there's laws for niggles. Let them start obeying.
What we saw last night and the night before in Los Angeles is not about civil rights.
Zippity-doo-dah, zippity-ay. My, oh my, what a wonderful day.
I should be shot. That's the only way we can stop them.
It's my way.
We must build a future where in every city across this country, empty rage gives way to hope, where poverty and despair give way to opportunity.
There are a new generation of Democrats, Bill Clinton and Al Gore, and they don't think the way the old Democratic Party did. They've called for an end to welfare as we know it, so welfare can be a... They've sent a strong signal to criminals by supporting the death penalty. And they rejected the old taxes, the new plan, investing in people, detailing $140 billion in spending cuts they'd make right now.
His carpetbagger friends done run the taxes way up sky high.
Clinton Gore, for people, for a change.
I believe we need to encourage personal responsibility.
You need all your valuables to sell for that tax money.
Our enemies are innovative and resourceful, and so are we. They never stop thinking about new ways to harm our country and our people, and neither do we.
The Department of Justice is also consulting with local authorities about ways that they can maintain public safety without restricting the right of peaceful protest and while avoiding unnecessary escalation. I made clear to the Attorney General that we should do what is necessary to help determine exactly what happened and to see that justice is done.
They are not just gangs of kids anymore. They are often the kinds of kids that are called super predators.
I was a Goldwater girl.
We have to bring them to heel.
We've got somebody saying here, we have to... You want to hear the facts, you just want to talk. Okay, back to the issues.
Thank you.
Yeah, if you're aspiring to this job, then you need to ask yourself some... You know, very serious questions about why you're doing it.
To every last person threatening the peace on our streets and the safety of our police, when I take the oath of office next year, I will restore law and order to our country. Believe me, believe me. In this race for the White House, I am the law and order candidate. I am your voice. I am your voice.
Can somebody tell me how to get things back the way they used to be? Oh God, give me the reason I'm down on bending knee.
Yeah.
Some had no opinion.